Good afternoon, madam. Myself Divya from Triple B. I am here to present you a presentation on the topic yoga. Before getting into the topic, I would like to ask you a question. How many of you do really practice yoga every day?
Only sound the
back. You can't hear. Reading them on yoga.
Getting into the topic, we all know that yoga has become a form of exercise every day. Moreover, it has also become a cultural discipline of practicing yoga. So, many of us perform yoga or near your surroundings. Can anyone describe yoga in simple words? Not this definition. Yes. Yoga is also called as union of mind and constitution, or body. Do you know that there are moreover 100 forms of diverse yoga forms which are rigorous in intents? Yoga is a form of art which is known to humanity over thousands of years. If you can see in this slide, you can see the meaning of the word yoga. The word yoga has been coming from the roots of the Sanskrit word yug. Yug means to unite and dwell. Yoga not only teaches you good health, but it also preaches you the truths of life. It's not being good at something, it's just being good to yourself. One cannot control the things which run outside, but one can always control the things which run inside your mind. History. We all know that yoga has been originated from Indus Saraswati civilization. The word both yoga was first mentioned in Rig Veda. The Vedas were the combination of songs and mantras which were used by Brahmins. Moreover, after slowly, the yoga was developed and refined by Brahmins and Rishis. International Yoga Day. We all know International Yoga Day, right? So, this is celebrated on 21st June. Do anyone know why it is celebrated only on 21st June?
It is a long day of holy year. 21st June
is considered as the longest day of the year. So, on that occasion, our Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji declared as 21st June as International Yoga Day. Benefits of yoga. There are many uses of yoga. Out of this, I have highlighted these points. Other than this, we also have physical benefits, like improving your blood circulation, improving your physical fitness, it gives you relaxation, it gives you stress relief, and it improves your concentration. How yoga transforms your body. In daily practice of yoga Daily practice of yoga gives you relaxed mind. Yoga also transforms your body in the following way. The patches marked in the blue are the transformations observed in your body for a few days. And the captions marked in green are the transformations observed in your body for a few months. And these, the rest, are the transformations that are observed in your body after practicing yoga for a few years. Practicing yoga does not give you instant change, but it gives you mental strength and it changes a human being to a human being yoga. Yoga is a journey of the self to the self to the self. This line is extracted from Bhagavad Gita. As we all know, Bhagavad Gita is one of the treasured and most spiritual texts. Bhagavad Gita is also known as a dialogue between Sri Krishna and Prince Arjuna during the battle between Kauravas and Pandavas. Bhagavad Gita preaches you the attainment of happiness through yoga. Friends, if you really see, our country has youth which are suffering from many diseases. So, I want to conclude you to that. Practice yoga and stay fit. Thank you. Any questions?
What is the difference between yoga and physical exercise?
Yoga is known as union of combination of mind and body. For combination of mind and body, we need concentration. Whereas for physical exercises, we don't need attention and concentration. So this is the difference between yoga and physical exercise. Thank you.
Manasa?
Tejashwini.
I don't think language is a barrier for you, right? What? I don't think language is a problem for you. But why you have taken the last presentation? I mean, last week, before last week, why didn't you come to give a presentation early?
Actually, the presentation was going on
Okay. Last week I was there, right? I think it was not Roll Number Vaish.
No, she was absent for last week. Before week, she was present there.
Last week you were absent?
Yes, she was absent. She was absent.
Okay. Your presentation is good, but I observe that, like, how you mug up some information just to you reproducing it. Do you understand that? When just you are explaining, it's not reaching to the explanation way. Whatever the information you mug up, like that information you produced. So little expanded it's required. And also your words, which are very...
They're very fast.
Fast, not fast. It starts abruptly. That, this, that's it. Understand? You're not giving an opportunity for others to think. You are stating, that's true. That's it. You have to listen like that. Okay? That you have to change. Because presentation, we are giving some information. We need to give the opportunity for others to think. Okay? Language is good. Voice is good. Body language, everything is good.
She's a bright student in my class.
Understood.
She's a very bright student.
But still you have to improve. Without your presentation, everything is good. A few things you have to improve to reach to the high level of the presentation, effectiveness of the presentation. Okay? Do you understand that?
Thank you.